student, how are you doing? Welcome to English lesson today. You know, during pandemic situation, you must keep your healthy, your spirit in study, and don't forget stay at home. Today, we are going to learn about expressing over and help. Now, let's go to see my explanation and let's see my slide soon.
Well, students, before we go to the explanation today, let's watch our video and concentrate with my video today.
Hello, sir. How are you?
Hello, ma'am. I'm fine. How about you?
I'm not well today.
Oh, yeah? You look so busy today.
Not at all.
Can I help bring your stuff?
Okay, which one do you want to first?
This one.
Thank you, sir.
You're welcome.
Hello, sir.
Oh, hello, ma'am.
How are you today?
I'm fine. How about you?
I'm fine too. You look so busy. What are you doing?
Oh, yeah. I'm writing a report.
Can I help you?
Oh, with my pleasure.
Which one should I do?
Please read this one for me.
Okay, I will do it in a minute.
Okay, thank you.
You're welcome.
Hello, students. How are you today? Nice to meet you again with me, Mrs. Anna Susilawati. Today, I will explain about offering help and service. Before I explain about expressing offering help and service, let's see the expression first, atau kita lihat dialognya dulu. Mr. George is cleaning his garden. He uses many gardening tools such as a sickle, hoe, spade, and big scissors. Billy is offering a help. What are you doing, Dad? I'm going to plant some vegetables. Can I help you? Yes, please. Clean the soil from the grass after I hoe. Certainly, Dad. Ya. Dari dialog itu, kita menemukan dua expressing, yaitu offering help sama accepting. Bagaimana ekspresinya? Ada can I help you? Acceptingnya adalah yes please. Ya, oke. Kalau sudah tahu contoh dialognya, kita menuju ke understandingnya. Offering help. Offering help adalah sebuah ekspresi yang digunakan untuk menawarkan jasa atau bantuan kepada orang lain. Ekspresinya bagaimana? What can I do for you? Kemudian, can I help you? Can I do something for you? Do you want something to eat? Or shall I get you something to read? Nah, itu ekspresinya offering, service, atau help. Nah, dalam expressing offering help sama service ini, kita mempunyai bentuk ekspresi formal dan informal. Nah, yang formal, ekspresinya bagaimana? Kita lihat di sini. Would you like some cake? Would you like a glass of milk? Jadi menggunakan expressing would you like, would you, ya, oke. Okay. Kemudian kalau yang tidak terlalu sopan atau tidak terlalu formal, bisa menggunakan do you want a cup of tea? Do you want a cup of coffee? Do you want a glass of milk? Ya, itu ya. Kemudian, kalau sudah memahami yang formal, kita menuju yang informal expression. Kalau informal, ekspresinya singkat, simple, dan gampang dihafalkan, yaitu have some coffee, have some cake, some sandwich. Tidak menggunakan ekspresi yang lebih formal, ya. Kalau orang Inggris biasanya menggunakan ekspresi yang lebih simple lagi. Fancy drink itu sama dengan do you want a drink, ya. Kemudian jika mau menawarkan sesuatu kepada seseorang yang belum tahu apa maunya, kita menggunakan can I get you something? Can I get you anything? Oke, kalau sudah tahu ekspresinya, kita menuju ke ekspresinya dalam bentuk kalimat. Contohnya yang informal. Do you want me to bring you a glass of milk? Should I get you some snack? I will get you a cup of coffee if you want it. Can I get you some drink? Kemudian ekspresi yang kedua, jika Anda ingin orang lain mendapatkan apa yang dia butuhkan, dapat menggunakan test milk, help yourself to some milk. Shall I help yourself to some milk? Kemudian let me get you some milk, ya. Jadi sambil menawarkan, ya. Itu yang informal. Di sini saya punya beberapa contoh ekspresi dalam bentuk kalimat. Bisa dilihat, ya, ada may I help you? Would you like to help me? Could you pass that over there, please? Would you like to come to my house? Jadi kamu bisa membedakan mana yang bentuk formal dan informal. Oke, kalau yang ini ekspresi dalam bentuk formal. Kemudian, kalau sudah tahu ekspresinya, kita menuju ke bagaimana kita menerima dan menolak expressing offer sama service. Untuk merespon atau menjawab, kamu cuma menjawab dengan yes please, thank you, thanks, thank you, that would be great, thank you, that's very kind of you, I'd like it very much, I'm pleased to do that, with pleasure, thank you, yes please, I really appreciate it, thank you, it's very kind of you, yes please, that would be lovely. Jadi itu kalau merespon expressing help, offering help sama service. Kemudian kalau menolak bagaimana ekspresinya? Di sini ada beberapa expression, yaitu ada no, thank you. No, it's okay, thank you. No, I'm fine, thank you. Please, don't bother. No, thanks. I can't, thanks anyway. No, I really won't, thank you. It's okay, I can do it myself. No, thank you. No, thanks. I don't need any help. Don't worry, I will do it myself. That's alright, I will manage it on my own. Yaitu beberapa expression untuk menolak tawaran orang lain. Nah, di sini saya sudah menyimpulkan ekspresi yang digunakan untuk accepting dan refusing. Bisa dilihat situ bagaimana acceptingnya bisa menggunakan salah satu atau refusing service. Kemudian, apabila Anda kepingin menggunakan kalimat untuk asking for help, meminta bantuan, bagaimana ekspresinya? Can you help me? Could you please give me a hand? Would you like to help me? Would you mind to come to my house? Could you pass the salt over there, please? Could you take the garbage outside? Could you bring me the newspaper? Could you please open the door? Could you lend me some money? Can you please come here for a second? Etc. So many things. Banyak sekali contohnya, ya. Nah, di sini saya ada beberapa contoh dialog dan ada pertanyaan. Silakan dipelajari dan silakan jawablah pertanyaan nomor 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Saya tunggu 15 menit dari sekarang. Lanjut dengan exercise 2. Kalian di sini tugasnya adalah membuat expression berdasarkan situasi yang sudah ada di kalimat masing-masing. Sudah ada contohnya. Waktunya 30 menit. Kemudian yang ketiga adalah menyusun dialog jadi kalimat yang betul atau jadi dialog yang betul tentang expressing over. Nah, yang terakhir adalah memilih saja, memilih jawaban dari A, B, C, D, manakah yang cocok dengan dialog dari soal nomor 1, 2, 3. Yang nomor 4 dan 5 melengkapi dialog yang hilang dengan memilih A, B, C, D yang sudah disediakan. Oke, student. Thank you for your attention today. I hope you understand. Don't forget, keep healthy and keep stay at home with your family. Don't go anywhere and keep study better. Bye-bye.